गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट, टुडे वी विल डिस्कस द कॉमन सोल्ट. व्हाट इज द फॉर्मूला ऑफ द कॉमन सोल्ट? यस स्टूडेंट, सोडियम क्लोराइड आर रॉ मटेरियल फॉर द केमिकल्स. सो दिस कॉमन सोडियम क्लोराइड ऑब्टेन इज एन इम्पोर्टेंट रॉ मटेरियल फॉर द वेरियस मटेरियल्स फॉर द डेली यूज सच एज द सोडियम हाइड्रोक्साइड ऑल्सो, बेकिंग सोडा, वॉशिंग सोडा, ब्लीचिंग पाउडर एंड मैनी मोर्स. So student, let us see how more substance is used for making all these different substances and how we will prepare the sodium hydroxide or any other salt from the common salt sodium chloride. So student, start. Sodium hydroxide, what is the formula of the sodium hydroxide? NaOH. So what will happen if electricity is passed through an aqueous solution of the sodium chloride? This is the aqueous solution. When with this salt we dissolve in water, prepare the aqueous solution and then pass the electricity, what will happen? The sodium chloride, when the electricity is passed through an aqueous solution of the sodium chloride, aqueous solution, this is called the solution brine. This is also called brine. So it decomposes and form sodium hydroxide. Listen carefully again. When electricity is passed through an aqueous solution of sodium chloride, so how do you prepare the aqueous solution? We dissolve sodium chloride in water and prepare the aqueous solution. Now pass the electricity in aqueous solution of the sodium chloride, and in other we can say that the brine, aqueous solution of sodium chloride also called brine. And when we pass the electricity in aqueous solution of the sodium chloride, so this sodium chloride decompose and form sodium hydroxide, understand, and also form the chlorine gas also and hydrogen also. So this process is also called chloralkali process. Why this is process is called the chloralkali process? Because the products formed, chlorine and alkali sodium hydroxide is alkali. What do you mean by the alkali? We have discussed in earlier video. Yes, those base dissolve in water are called alkali. So student, this reaction is known as the chloralkali reaction. Chlor means chlorine and alkali means sodium hydroxide. Understand? So what is the reaction? Sodium chloride plus water liquid, and this is the aqueous solution of the sodium chloride, and it decomposed while the electricity passed. So sodium hydroxide plus chlorine plus hydrogen gas evolved. Now this, when we pass the electricity, this chlorine gas is given off the anode. Chlorine gas is give off at the anode. Give off at the anode, you can see this cylinder anode, and hydrogen gas is in the cathode. And if we talk about the sodium hydroxide also is produced, so this sodium hydroxide is formed near the cathode. So student, three product produced in this process. Three product, what are these? Sodium hydroxide, chlorine and hydrogen. And also there are many uses this product. What are these? You can see this picture clearly, and it is made from the salt, aqueous solution of the salt. See, very interesting. And when we pass the electricity in the aqueous solution of the sodium chloride, three products are formed, and three products also have the many uses. So first of all we will discuss the hydrogen gas, and it is formed at the cathode. What are the uses? And this hydrogen gas also used as a fuels also, and we can say that the ammonia for the fertilizers also. You can see fertilizers also and margarine also. And if we talk about student chlorine, what are the uses of the chlorine? Understand, I think you know, water treatment plants, swimming pools also, PVC disinfectants also. Understand? Now if we talk about this hydrogen and chlorine react together and form hydrogen chloride. Understand? When electricity pass, because understand, when we electricity pass, what will happen? Hydrogen chloric acid. And what is the uses of the hydrochloric acid? In cleaning steel also, and formation of the ammonium chloride, medicines and cosmetic also. These are the use of the hydrochloric acid. Understand? Now, if we talk about the sodium hydroxide, is a alkyl. So, what is the use of the sodium hydroxide? And this sodium hydroxide used in the paper making, degreasing metals, artificial fibers, soap and detergent. This is a very important part of this chapter. This is a soap. One question always come in the board exam. And what is the uses of the NaOH? Degreasing metals, soap and detergents, paper making and artificial fiber. And when these react together, we can say the bleach. And both alkali also and chlorine also use as a household bleach and bleaching fabric. So these are the important products from the chloralkali process. I hope you understand what are the uses of the hydrogen, chlorine and sodium hydroxide. Okay, student? Okay, next. Now we will discuss the bleaching powder. Bleaching powder. What is the formula of the bleaching powder? Yes, student. Calcium oxychloride. Calcium oxychloride. Bleaching powder. And how we will prepare this bleaching powder? We have already come to know that the chlorine is produced during the chloralkaline process. During the electrolysis of the aqueous sodium chloride prime. So this chlorine gas is used to for the manufacturing of the bleaching powder. Bleaching powder is produced by the action of the chlorine on the slaked lime. You can see. This is the slaked lime. Yeah, lime water. You can see the calcium hydroxide. And when the chlorine react with slaked lime, what will happen? They form the bleaching powder, calcium oxychloride. And it is a, we can say that the it is a composition reaction. Actual composition reaction is quite complex. It is very, we can say that in simple way, is difficult way. It is a complex. So, understand. So, bleaching powder. This is a bleaching powder. Other name of the bleaching powder in chemical, calcium oxychloride. Calcium oxychloride, a bleaching powder, is formed by the action of the chlorine on slaked lime. And this bleaching powder is represented as the calcium oxychloride. Understand? This is a complex process. Okay? Understand? So, you can see the chlorine is used for, and chlorine is produced by the chloralkali process, and this chlorine is used also as a manufacturing of the bleaching powder. Now, what are the uses of the bleaching powder? This student, bleaching powder is used as a, we can say that the textile industry, bleaching cotton and linen also, and for bleaching wood pulp in paper factory also, and for bleaching wash cloth, and it is also used as a oxidizing agent. We have discussed what are the oxidizing agent, and in many chemical industry, and also it is used as a disinfecting drinking water to make it free from the germs. So student, these are the uses of the bleaching powder. What are the uses of the bleaching powder? For bleaching cotton, linen in the textile industry, for bleaching wood pulp in paper factories, for bleaching washed cloth in laundry, used as a oxidizing agent in many chemical industries, and for disinfecting drinking water to make it free of germs. I think you understand what I am saying. So student, now we will discuss the baking soda. And what is the other name of the baking soda? We have discussed in earlier video, baking soda, sodium hydrogen carbonate or sodium bicarbonate. So if we talk about the baking soda, soda commonly used in the kitchen, in our kitchen, for making the tasty, crispy things also, food also, like pakora. And sometimes it added for the faster cooking also. It makes the cooking faster. And the chemical name of the compound is sodium hydrogen carbonate. And how it is prepared? And so student, it is produced using the sodium chloride as one of the raw material. It is prepared by the sodium chloride. When sodium chloride, aqueous solution of the sodium chloride, react with carbon dioxide and ammonia, form ammonium chloride and sodium hydrogen carbonate. This is a very important thing. Understand? So, when the aqueous solution of the sodium chloride pass the carbon dioxide and ammonia gas, and the baking soda will be produced. Now, did you check the pH of the sodium hydrogen carbonate in activity 2.14? We will discuss in next. So, can you correlate why it is used to neutralize an acidic? If we talk about sodium hydrogen carbonate, listen student, it is a basic in nature, because it is a basic in nature, because it is used to neutralize the acid. It is a non-corrosive base. And when we heat, the following reaction takes place when it is heated. When we heat the sodium hydrogen carbonate, what will happen? It goes the various uses when we heat. So sodium hydrogen carbonate has got various uses in household old work. Now we will discuss, if we heat the sodium hydrogen carbonate, what will be formed? Sodium carbonate plus H2O plus CO2. Understand? Now what are the uses of the sodium hydrogen carbonate, or sodium bicarbonate, or baking soda? Generally student, it is a mild edible acid. We can say that if we talk about, it is a basic in nature. But if we talk about the baking powder, so student, we are using baking powder in our kitchen. So it is a mixture of the baking soda and mild edible acid such as tartaric acid. So when baking powder is heated or mixed in water, what will happen? Generally the carbon dioxide will be produced during the reaction. And what is the use of this carbon dioxide? It causes the bread or cakes to rise, making them soft and spongy. And also, what are the other uses of the baking soda? It is also used as the ingredient in antacid, and being alkaline, because it neutralizes the acid. It is used as an antacid, and it is also basic in nature. So it also neutralizes excess acid in the stomach and provide relief. And student, it is also used in the soda acid fire extinguishers. Understand? So there are the many uses of the baking soda. This is a very important topic. So student, I hope you understand what is the baking soda and how do you prepare the baking soda, and what are the uses of the baking soda. Okay, now student, for making the baking powder, you can say that is not a only single mixture of the baking soda. It is a mixture of the baking soda and tartaric acid. Understand? So when the baking soda is heated or mixed in water, the following reactions, and when we add in the food material, what will happen? It produces the carbon dioxide gas also, and this carbon dioxide used in the causes the bread and cake to rise, making them soft and spongy. And it is also used as a soda acid fire extinguisher, and it is also used in the antacid, being alkaline, it neutralizes the excess acid in the stomach and provide relief. So students, I hope you understand. In next video, we will discuss the next salt, washing soda also, and other also copper sulfate also, and gypsum and plaster paste. Okay students, bye.